I wanted to die. There was a number of times I thought about killing myself. There's, it crushed me. It crushed me. I hated hockey. I hated life. But it's all I knew, so I was so deeply invested in it that I didn't know what else. I didn't know anything else. And I was like, I'm a hockey player, Brock McGillis hockey player. It's just who I was. But there's a number of times I thought about taking my life.
So what was it like being gay as a hockey player?
It was probably the hardest, the biggest struggle I've ever had. It was so difficult. It was, I lied. I lied to myself, I lied to the world, I lied to everyone in my life, and I was never happy.
I mean, the hockey and sports environment for a member of the LGBTQ community is not an easy one to be in. Some of the language that is used in the locker rooms, can you talk to me about that and how that made you feel, realizing that maybe you were gay?
I, from a young age, start to hear sexist and homophobic language, and ultimately there's racist language as well in sport and in locker rooms in general. But the sexist language and homophobic language really stuck with me. Because the sport is so hyper-masculine, men tend to put each other down within the sport by either feminizing or using homo-negative language. And that homo-negative language, it's like saying that this is a man, and if you're a woman or you're gay, you're less than a man. Yeah. And I sat there and I thought, like, oh geez, I can't be this. I can't be this because, like, then I can't play hockey.
Yeah.
And from a very young age, I tried to suppress who I was.
Tell me about the moment when you realized that you were over-hiding your sexuality.
By the age of 18, I started drinking daily.
Yeah.
I was suicidal. I hated myself. Every day I wanted to die. I couldn't even look at myself in the mirror. That went on for years. Finally, at 23, I was living in Europe. I was living just outside of Amsterdam. And would have been a really cool place to be gay. But I was hiding it, and I finally sat myself down one day, and I'd had my career derailed. I went from being on an NHL draft list to probably being a pick. All of a sudden, I'm playing minor leagues of Europe. And sat myself down, and I said, you need to figure this out. Because I knew two things were going to happen. One, my career was coming to an end. Two, I was likely to end up dead. You can't drink every day for 5 years, be suicidal, be depressed and all this, and not have, you know, a bad outcome.
I was watching a hockey game. I was going to school at Concordia at the time, and I saw Brendan Burke. Brendan had come out that night publicly and with the support of his father and his family.
He's the son of Brian Burke?
Yes, former GM of the Toronto Maple Leafs, and now he's the president of the Calgary Flames.
I think it's important that my story is told to people because there are a lot of gay athletes out there that deserve to know that there are safe environments where people are supportive of you regardless of your sexual orientation.
I reached out to him. We had the hockey world's very small, so I was fortunate I had mutual friends, and I got in contact with him through Facebook, and we started chatting and finally had somebody who understood me without judgment, without fear of outing me, without anything. And it was such a special bond because I think he felt like he had somebody who appreciated what he was going through at the same time, being in the hockey world and trying to be a trailblazer in it. And Brendan obviously passed away. 2 days before he died, we were talking on Facebook, and at the end of the conversation, he wrote to me, I can't wait till you're out to your family like I am to mine. I just looked at that and I was so taken aback. I didn't know what to think. I'm like, why would he say that? And I think he knew how deep my struggle was and how bad I felt. And then he passed away and I was grieving alone. I was all alone. I had nobody in my life who knew that I was gay, let alone that somebody I become so close with in a short period of time passed away. And I told my brother. I came out to him after that.
How'd that go?
Didn't change a thing, and my brother was playing professional hockey. He hugged me, and our relationship has been the same, if not better, ever since.
To date, you can correct me, but I don't think there's a single NHL player who has ever, ever come out.
There isn't.
Is it possible there's nobody who's gay? I mean, I don't want to out anybody, but...
How could there not be? How can you have close to 800 people in a group? And I think the statistic is approximately 10% of the population is gay, and none of these 800 people, plus management and coaches and everyone else.
Do you think that professional sports is a welcoming environment for gay players?
I think it could be tough. I mean, you never know. I think that there's a lot of people out there that that have opinions that probably aren't very welcome, and not just not just players. I would say that there could be a lot of different responses, and that can be another factor why there's probably not many people that have come out as professional athletes.
A lot of the language that's used, even by sportscasters and journalists, this whole idea about being a sissy, or we hear this all the time. How should we be combating this?
Oh man, I think it's something that. That's almost like you were saying. It's used not in a way that maybe is meant to mean certain things. It's almost ingrained in us, coming up.
The homophobic slur that was allegedly said recently at an NHL game. Yeah. I have to talk to you about that.
But we've seen this from the league in the past.
Yeah.
With different incidents. There was an incident with Ryan Getzlaf where he made homophobic comments and the league deemed them not homophobic.
Yeah.
And there's constantly been instances like this that they have to be better at, because they have such a social impact on our culture that by allowing somebody to say those words, yeah. it's allowing kids to say those words. It's giving validation to homophobic people. And I think it's really important that people recognize that you can't say that. I tried to kill myself on a number of occasions just from that language.
Yeah.
And they need to recognize that has such a massive impact. Kids are quitting hockey. Kids are quitting sport. They want nothing to do with it at a young age because they're queer and they don't feel comfortable around it.
Yeah.
And that's horrible. I think there needs to be a two-tiered model where we educate fans, because fan culture is incredibly toxic.
Yep.
Players at professional levels, management, coaches at professional levels, and then take them down to minor sports and do a grassroots initiative where, as you're educating these people, you're educating these kids, and then it kind of slowly, gradually improves.
And having NHL players stand up and be those role models to young people is a huge statement. It's the kind of statement that doesn't just change lives, it can actually save a young person's life.
I think in our lifetime we will see gay hockey players in the NHL. I really do. I think that slowly there's a shift in society, and I think whether it's the current group that's there or the future group, if we can implement these programs and make people aware of their language and how it's affecting their teammates, the players they're playing against and everyone else, that'll shift.
Do you have a message for anything?
You will feel better, you will be happier, and you will be stronger when you learn to love yourself for who you are.
Are you happier?
I am.
Yeah?
I am. I love being a gay man. I'm happy that I'm me. I don't feel like I have to hide. I'm so happy.